There's multiple advantages to Hdr brachytherapy. One of those advantages is that we've already mentioned that the patient does not have to go home with any radiation. So there's no precautions at home or anything like that. The customization of the treatment plan can be all done on the computer, and we know exactly what we're delivering ahead of time. So that's certainly an advantage. Another advantage to the Hdr brachytherapy is that that radioactive source can be left in positions at different lengths of time, and so it can pause for a certain amount of time that we've predetermined. So it might give a little bit more radiation in this location, it maybe gives a little bit less in this location. So our customizability, or the ability for us to really shape and direct that dose, is very precise, and we can give a little bit more over here, or if we're next to something we don't want to treat, we can minimize the dose there. So that's a definite advantage. One of the major quality of life advantages, which is a very short treatment time. So there are patients that are candidates to do what we call monotherapy, or the only therapy is the brachytherapy. And right now I'm doing two different implants. So it takes 2 days, and one could have all the prostate cancer treated in basically 2 days. When we're all done, then the catheters are removed. We turn off the epidural. The patient goes upstairs to the recovery room and lets their legs wake up after the anesthetic wears off. And as long as they can walk around and urinate, then we let them go home. So oftentimes they're home for dinner on the same day. And then we wait 2 weeks, and then we would repeat it again. So in basically 2 days, one can have their prostate cancer treated. So it's a very convenient method for folks that either live a long ways away or have lots of other things going on that need to have a more shortened kind of treatment. The prostate, its location is a pretty critical location, because it sits just below the bladder, it sits just in front of the rectum, it sits just basically on top of a small muscle that keeps men from leaking urine or having incontinence. There's also nerves that run next to the prostate that could affect sexual function, so erectile function. So any of those organs are potentially at risk, and so we have to be very careful about that, and we try to do our best to minimize those risks. Some of the long-term side effects, I mean long-term, it could be months down the road or even years down the road. There's certainly a chance that the urinary tube could have some scar tissue form in it, which makes it harder to urinate in the future. There could be, it's very uncommon to have incontinence problems or leakage problems, but it certainly can happen. That risk is probably on the order of 1 or 2% is all. There certainly is a possibility of affecting the erections. So just about any prostate cancer treatment, unfortunately, because the nerves run so close to the prostate, one can affect erections and have lower ability to have erections or affect sexual function. We're trying to keep the side effects either the same or less with any of the new advances, and that's one of the things that we try to do in medicine, is if we're going to advance something, we want to make it better, but also at least as good or perhaps better on the side effect profile. So I would say it's very, very comparable in that regard in erectile function to other radiation procedures.